Hi, Paul Hutchison from PC Dev Limited here. I went to Google I.O. and on the first day in the keynote speech, they had one of these Labyrinths. And they were controlling it using an Android tablet. Now, I was a bit inspired by this. I grew up with one of these tablets, and in fact, this is the very tablet that I grew up with. Now, I went over to my parents' place and raided their cupboards. I finally found it. Had a lot of dust and stuff through it, but what I've done is I've taken the base off and made some modifications. So instead of having the servos on the outside, they only supplied us with a couple of small servos, and I didn't really have the time to purchase any additional servos for this project. So I added the servos that they gave me underneath here. I've added a lever arm connected to a spring here. And the spring just gives it a bit of stability and also protects the servos from any sudden movements. So we have two axes here. We've got that movement, and we've also got that movement. This is just a direct connection through to the servos. The accessory development board comes in two parts. This is the case that it came in from Google I.O. The board has the Arduino base, and it also has a special Google Android shield that fits on top, and this just provides a few common interfaces to various things for demonstration and testing. So the two just slot together, fairly straightforward. We plug in the power, we plug in the USB. Okay, we also have to plug in my little plug from the back of the maze here. Plug that into the servo outputs, and you just hear them moving there. Okay, finally on the phone, there is a little Demokit application that comes on the accessories.android.com website. So I've downloaded that, compiled it, and installed it on my phone. It's asking me to connect a Demokit board, so when I plug this in, it should recognize it. And I just click OK, say yes, I want to use the development board with this application. Go to the outputs, and I can adjust the servos. Okay, so you can see I can adjust those there. Now, I took it a little bit further because I actually found that what I wanted to do was actually have a, you know, those tilt mazes that you can use your phone to turn them around. Well, I wanted to do the same thing as they did on the stage. So I've taken the Demokit application and modified it and called it RealMaze, because it's not one of those mazes that you see on your screen, it's the real thing. So what I've done is fairly straightforward, and it just allows you to tilt the phone and it tilts the maze. It's got a little display on there, it's nothing really special, but so you can hear those servos moving, working along there in the background. Well, we'll see how I go then. Not too good on the first try. Well, a little better on the second try, but you can see that it's a fairly straightforward application. Just takes the accelerometer data straight from the phone, feeds it into the board, and the board translates that into servo signals. Well, actually the phone does a lot of that work. Yeah, that's it from me. Thanks.